the life of your sake. Hear me, I declare his obituary today.
I met a young boy, Onome is his name. Onome is from Edo State. Went for a program, I met him somewhere. And we exchanged numbers and I left. After praying for him, we left. After some days, he called me and he told me, Father, I am an operator in Shell, and I make money. He said, Papa, do you know, if I make money, I've tried to build a house for up to 4 times now. But anytime I'm about to go, I lay a foundation, one problem will come, and the whole money will wipe away. I will lose everything. I said, what do you mean? He said, sir, the first I wanted to be there, I became sick. I wasted the whole money on my sickness. The moment the money finished, I became well. All of a sudden. He said, the second time, the third time, I was driving and I hit a child. And the guy died and they said, I must bury the person. That was how the money left. He said, everything, I always have a problem. This money. I told him, sir, that is a lie. It's a line of limitation to control your wealth. That is, they are trying to stop you. And he said, Papa, I know. But he told me, Papa, I want to build a house. I said, you want to build a house? He said, yes. He said, you want to build a house? He said, yes. I said, okay. We started praying. I will pray. One midnight, God said to me, tell him, he should go and give his pastor clothes. I called him and said, Oga, go and beautify your pastor. He said, how do you mean? I said, how many things do you have to wear? She said, yeah, but I noticed that my pastors have only 4 suits every day. We don't wear this one today, this one. I said, good. I said, okay, you buy 10 suits for your pastor. 10. The boy said, Papa, no problem. I believe you, whatever you say. Say, go and buy it. After buying it, wait for her. You will see what will happen. He said, no problem. He went and bought 10 suits. If you see suits, I saw the pictures, I became jealous of suits. The guy sent it to his pastor. His pastor called me and said, man of God, God bless you. The man started crying. Nobody, I've been looking for a way to wear suits. Sometimes your pastor, they suffer, you know, they know. He will come here and pray for you and pray for you and cry for you. Most times, he doesn't even have money to give food for his own family. But yet, he's praying for you to buy food to give your family. Hear me today, if you don't know how to take care of your pastor, take care of your pastor. Are you hearing me? See, hear me. Prosperity lies in the hands of a man of God. The Bible says, believe in me, believe in my prophet, and you shall do what? Shall prosper. Prosperity is tied in the mouth of your prophet. So if you want to prosper, look at your pastor, help him. So after some time, this guy called and said, Papa, I want to go to the village. He went to the village, did foundation, did everything. Now, as the thing got to a lethal level, the thing stopped. I told him it's not possible. Except I don't hear God, it's not possible. I told him a man wants to limit you. He told me, Papa, I don't know. I said, nah, let me shock you. I empower you. God will expose the man between 7 days. The young man said, amen, on phone. You can then. After some days, this young man called me on phone. He told me, Papa, there is fire on the mountain. I told him, what is the problem? He said, sir, do you know that they called me from village? They have been calling me, my father have been calling me, my mother have been calling me. They will tell me, come back. I said, I don't want to come back. But now, my king called me on phone. I said, what is the problem? He said, I should come back. There is fire on the mountain. I said, no problem. I said, go. And he went to the village. He said, as he got to the village, he called me and he was shouting, Papa, oh God, don't do something with them, man. I did shake. In fact, as I did, I don't become big poor. I said, what happened? He said, Papa, I got to the village park. I didn't go with my car. I went to the village park. The king sent his chief to come and carry me. I entered the community. Everybody was looking at me as one God. And everybody was afraid of me. I said, what is the problem? What happened? He told me, he entered the village and they took him to a house of one man. He entered the house and looked and he saw that the roof was broken. I said, what happened? He said, as he entered the house, he was hearing a man calling, Aname, help me, Aname, help me. I entered and I asked the man, what happened? He said, Aname, see, they built the house. I go your house. I mean, they stop you, sis, to build that house. Now, for night, as they call your name, bomb that knock from heaven, hand knock my head, and if you stand up till today. Knock. Knock. Scatter the ceiling. Enter my house. Break. Knock my head. Now, I know if you stand up again. Somebody shout power. Any man that needs to fall for you to rise, I say it again, let that man fall. Oh, yes.
Remember there. And I told him, what did you tell him? He said, Papa, I don't know if I could tell him. King said, make I say anything. I said, man, it's time to make money. He said, he doesn't have. I said, okay, demand for money. He said, what? I said, tell the king, say they will finish your house. No problem. He told the king, king said, we'll finish your house for you. Then the king said, my car don't hold. When I go buy a new car, he said, he said, you go refund me all the money when I don't use one week before. He said, no problem. And the man, the king ordered an emergency panel meeting and money. They paid him 10 million into this boy's account. 10 million. And the boy said, I release you in Jesus' name. Amen. The man stood up and walked away. Lie. Life. Every evil man in your community stopping the success and the progress of young men, stopping your own success. Hey, there has drawn a line of limitation over your business, your life, and your endeavor. I prophesy under God, under this holy altar, let it die. Oh, God.